Hello, I'm Carla Littleton, Animal and Habitats Coordinator here at the Carnegie Science Center. And we're here because even during our closure, we have to continue giving quality care to our animal ambassadors. As you see, I am practicing social distancing. There's no one else here with me, but we need to remain here to take care of our animal friends. And today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about our Eastern Milksnake. Now, the Eastern Milksnake is part of the king snake family. It's a very common species here in Pennsylvania. Sometimes we will see them red, like this one is. Other times, the dark red portion will be gray. And this species, though it is non-venomous, does have Batesian mimicry, which means its pattern mimics a venomous snake. Now, there are two snakes that it can be confused with. One is the copperhead, and the other is the coral snake. And that helps protect this species. If it's seen in the wild, a predator that would eat it, something like a possum or a raccoon, might stop and question whether or not this is a venomous snake. And it gives that snake time to get away. In the wild, this species will eat a variety of things, including small lizards, other snakes, frogs, and sometimes toads. It will also eat mice, which is part of its primary diet. Insects sometimes, especially when they're young, but at this size, mostly rats and mice and small birds, potentially bird eggs from ground-dwelling bird species, would all be on the menu for this snake. Here at the Carnegie Science Center, we feed him a mixture of small mice, and he also gets quail chicks to fulfill his diet. Variety is very important for our snakes to remain healthy. He is now about 5 years old, which is a fairly young. He could live 15 or 20 years very easily. He is not full grown. So if we back up and we unroll him, we can see his length. He could get up to about 4 feet in length as an adult. Probably not much bigger than that. I'm probably smaller overall, probably 3.5 feet. Will be his size when he is an adult. This snake is often out if you're here at the Science Center. Animal staff will sometimes have this species out for our visitors to interact with and pet to see up close. We can see his tongue is flicking out right now as he tries to smell the environment. So sometimes people are afraid of snake tongues, and actually that is serving as their nose. And the tongue flips out and then it goes into the roof of the mouth, into the Jacobson's organ. And that organ is their sense of smell. So instead of a nose picking up scent particles from the air, their tongue is doing that. When you get a chance to come back to the Science Center, I encourage you to take a look at our Eastern Milksnake. And if you have any questions, be sure to ask our staff that's on hand.